First of all, greetings everyone! My name is Humanarian, I have come here all the way from Russia. It's a great pleasure to be here today, to meet all of you guys. And of course, to hold my very own panel at the GalaCon. And I thank you all for coming here, because seriously, I was afraid to be greeted with an empty hall or something. But anyway, as you could have probably guessed from the title of my panel, and and the short description that you all have. And my panel is going to be about poetry, both in my little pony friendship magic and in general. Like, what's the rhyme, what kind of rhymes there really are. But it's not going to be a lecture, no. Lectures are boring, it's going to be a fun interaction with you guys. That's why it's so important that all of you are here today. So, let us begin. And, of course, first of all, let me introduce you to my master. Well, the introduction, that is what just happened. Then, I'm going to talk a bit about poetry in My Little Pony. It's wrong there. And then, we're going to take a look at the poetry and the rhyme, speak about the different templates of rhymes, and then the most important part of the panel is masterclass time, when each of you will be able to contribute to creating a real poem. And of course, then, as the tradition, will be a Q&A section. So, let us begin with poetry in My Little Pony. So when you even hear the phrase poetry in My Little Pony, what is the first thing that comes to your mind?
The songs.
The songs, yeah. And to me too, the musical numbers, of course. And indeed, they are one of many things that make the show so special. But here's the question. Could a good musical number, a musical number really be awesome without some good lyrics? And the answer is probably no. If you want a musical number to be catchy, you need the lyrics to be catchy as well. And the show has it, but what does it even mean, catchy? Well, you can probably tell if your song is catchy or not if you just take a look at the audience and see it for yourself if they are already singing along. And I'm pretty sure it was the case with the most of you when you heard any musical number from MLP, even for the first time. That's what I call catchy. And you don't even need to carefully pick up a song from the show to get one with catchy lyrics. What I mean is, we need to wrap up. Raise this bar, the smile song. I just mentioned those, but I'm pretty sure each of you has just remembered the whole lyrics. Now that's catchy. They're simple, they are easy to understand, and they are pleasant to the ear. So that's a quick recital of the catchy lyrics. But when it comes to poetry, the show goes kind of beyond just the musical numbers. I'm pretty sure some of you might already have an idea of what I'm referring to. And if you have not, here comes our first riddle.
The true identities of the deer, a mystery before us. She's not like everyone here. She is living in the forest. Sometimes her ways of life confuse. But leave it for tomorrow. She is a friend. Better choose.
What is her name?
Zikora.
That's right, Zikora. So, yeah, that's her. So, in My Little Pony Princess Magic, we have an entire character that uses poetry as one of many other things that make her unique. So far, there is no other character who writes all the time in the show. And it has not even made clear if it's Zikora sings specifically, or just a trait of the entire Zikora race. We have never seen the other member of the Zikora race. least yet. But one thing is for sure, the Gora never opens her mouth without a rhyme or two coming out. And then goes straight into her character description, giving the show, the poetry, the very phenomenon of poetry, a special meaning in the show. Well, I fully understand that what I am about to say is completely subjective, but the poetry is kind of one of the main things that has attracted me to the show. I mean, yes, I love the message the show tries to get across. I love the characters, I love the animation, I love the voice acting, the universe, everything. But I'm always super excited to hear a new musical number. And I'm sure each of you might actually share that with me. Because those never disappoint. Neither in music, Daniel Ingram does a fantastic job. Nor in the lyrics. After all, isn't that the reason why we keep listening to those musical numbers even separately from the show? Like, just on our phone or something. The kitchen lyrics, the kitchen tunes, they make sure we can never get enough of them. But let us get a bit distracted from the show for a moment and speak about the poetry itself, the rhyme and its different kinds. What does the rhyme even mean? Now, here I could go full twilight and say something like, rhyme is a correspondence of sound between words or the ending of words, especially when these are used at the ends of lines of poetry. Like, what? Where's the fun in that? As I told you before, it's not a lecture. So, let's just say that the words rhyme when they sound similar. You know, like milk and syrup, ice and ice. Or they would just sound similar in the end, like phenomenon and GalaCon. You get what I'm saying, right? After all, it's GalaCon. Here we must have a blast. Actually, that sounds kind of like make a nice slogan for GalaCon. Anyway, now that we know what rhyme is, let's take a look at different ways of using it. And let us begin with the classic one. The template number one. So-called ABAB template. When the first line rhymes with the third and the second one rhymes with the fourth. It's one of the most commonly used templates. But once again, where is the fun in looking at just some letters on the screen? Yeah, that's why here come a few riddles to illustrate that rhyme. The master of the fashion, of dresses and their rarity, shall make you look like a treasure. That's no one else but
rarity.
Rarity, that's correct. That's totally correct. Now, the next one. She's the magic itself in the body, with the sign on her flag to be. She's a princess, a friend, one and only, and she's known by the name?
Ludwigsburg.
That's right! That's totally the princess. What's that? Do you think those are too easy for you? Well then, it comes in a much more sophisticated world. Pay attention. The voice of wisdom lives with knowledge. The rose sometimes hits like a bang. Advice is always in the storage. But who is that? That's correct! Dude, you are brilliant! Yeah, that's Spike the Dragon. And I mean, yeah, that character never gets enough respect. I think he deserves much more respect than he actually gets. I mean, yeah, the whole first one while asking, but he would use some more respect from his older ones, his older friends, and better to him. So, now I'm sure you can see why I call that template classic. That type of rhyme is most commonly used anywhere in the songs, in the poems, but that doesn't mean it's the only one. Of which, here is another template used that can be used for a bit more sophisticated poems. It's an ABBA template where the first line rhymes with the last and the two cheer as he is by. Across the town and back again. The biggest fan of chocolate, right? And pie maker? Pinkie Pie, that's correct. She's watching here. The next one. The cutest type of the invaders. They break into your life as well and teach you much about yourself. They are
the
Kingdom of Crusaders, correct. Those three beauties are always there to help you figure out your special talent. Now, the third one. She spreads around the cheer and glee and makes the learning really fun. The children laugh like a mug as they say hi. Miss Cheerily, yeah. That's totally our teacher. Oh, and I have almost completely forgot. Yeah, I'm having so much fun with you guys. I actually had prepared a quick compilation of how each template is used in the show, in the musical numbers in the show. So, yeah, previously we were talking about ABA beta plate, the classical one. So here comes a beautiful illustration. But As you can see, the songs are really usually more creative, and some tunes might need a specific rhyme, specific kind of rhyme to fit in perfectly. So that's why I wanted to introduce you to another template, which I cannot call classic. See, it's a AABCCB template, and I'm pretty sure I could explain each rhyme, each line that rhymes with which. But I'm sure you have already got the message. You have already got this. Plus, it's not like I'm going to leave this special one without an illustration. So here goes another bunch of wheels. Hardworking, non-talking, a kind of country kind of posh. He's modest and honest. He is
Big Macintosh.
Nope. Yeah, that's something here. Yeah. The next one. She's so fat, just like a blast, a mare to admire. Show what you got, she likes it hot. She's got a name?
Spitfire. Anyone getting the reference to one of many pony songs here?
Anyway. The next one. Yeah, the next one. The floating mind, the twisted kind, the fun you can't afford. He turns your town right upside down. What is his name?
Disco.
That's something. Yeah. And of course, I do have an illustration from the show, but this one is going to be special, because I'm going to show you a few musical numbers where that template is used in a pure form, just like it is. And then there will be a few musical numbers where there are some variations and extensions of it. And in the end, we're going to see an example when that template is completely reversed, like upside down.
Speaking of disco.
Yeah. So here goes, enjoy.
Hush. Hush now, quiet now, it's time to go to bed.
We don't have our beds, we don't have the same moments. We remember everything we should. But there's something that's quite unique. When my sister is there with me, and we can share that special bond as sisterhood.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can see that the Bob Seed song is a complete reversal of that template. Right? Completely upside down. But I'm having a feeling that I'm actually forgetting some other word. What could it be? Ah, yeah, of course! It's the AABB template. You know, where each pair of lines rhyme with each other. And some songs really excel by combining that template. But that's just my opinion. Let's take a look for ourselves. Not much of wheels. She's modest, gentle, like an angel. She shows a kindness to the stranger. She shrill soothing voice when they cry. Of course, he's
Fluttershy, yeah. A lot of ponies think they are, that is the best pony.
Speaking of best ponies, he comes to the next.
The pony well known by the number of one. There isn't a thing that she couldn't have done. And when her friends meet her, she's there in the flesh. We all want to meet her. She is
in the flesh.
Totally.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah. And the last one.
So hardworking and gorgeous, she won't let you down. She's one of the most well-known ponies in town. If she gave you her word, then she won't take it back. You might know of her, fellas. She is?
Yeah,
you are a great audience today.
So,
well, surely there are other things to say.
Yeah, Applejack and Applejack Flash. Yeah.
Yay. Awesome. Well, surely there are other things to say about poetry, like, you know, the number of syllables and in different lines, and how strike falls on this prestigious syllables, but that would be a lecture. And the lectures are not no fun at the event like this. So that's just why we are going to move on to the next and the most special part of this step. It's master work. Now, surely it's a lot of fun to enjoy a good song or with some really good lyrics or to hear the poem in the most sacred strings of your soul. But have you ever tried to make a poem on your own? I know. A lot of you are going to say like something like, it requires a special talent, or
it's too hard, I can't come up with a rhyme.
Yeah, but guess what? By the end of this very panel, each of you who dares to give it a try is going to be able to say, I contributed to creation a real poem today. How is it possible? Well, you're about to find out.
See? I have prepared something. It's a poem,
but something is missing.
It's incomplete.
And that is where you guys come in. I want to hear all about your ideas. All about your ideas for each part of the poem. And as the poem goes on, we will make sure those ideas come to life and make their way into the poem and become a part of it. And in the end, with your help, of course, this poem is going to come out unique. But don't worry, I'm not going anywhere. I'm here to help you and make sure your ideas become the part of this poem. And so I'm asking you, are you ready for the test?
Yes!
Yeah! Will there be anyone who says no?
Yeah!
Yeah!
So let's just pick
up a character. Who is for Violet Farquhar? Spike is not one of the main six. He's one of the main seven. Who is for Rainbow Dash? Yeah? Who's for Apple Jack? You don't vote for Apple Jack. Okay. Who's for Fluttershy? Yeah. So basically, it's about the same amount.
Where's
the
first one?
Where's the, yeah. Then again, where would they meet? summer. And there are quite some sights to see. So, the idea?
I would say the sea is an expert for the park they have.
The park they have? Ah, yeah. No, but not the sea.
Because the rest is free.
It's for free. Ah.
Right.
Okay, okay. So it's the kind, it's like a picnic outside. On the coast of that lake or river, let's just call it river for the sake of, you know, for the sake of catching it down. So, the river. But you see, we have a problem here. We need to make sure it rides. So, free kind of like rides with river. But there is another way to get it down, to make sure it rhymes. For example, she had the day completely free, just one thing to attend. The river is the place to be, to meet with all her friends. How does that sound to you? Yes, okay, let's go with that. While I'm writing that down, here is the other part. With the different, is it different? No, it's not the different. Ah, yeah, yeah. I want it to be a different kind of rhyme. Yeah, it's going to be A B B A template. So the first line will have to rhyme with the last. We are going to make a poem in different kinds of rhymes. We are going to use different ones just to, you know, to see how what we learned today can be used. So, think of your ideas for now, while I'm writing the river part down. Yeah, I cut it down. So, they had the plans that all males love. First, having some girl time. Then,
first having some girl time, cupcakes frosted in line. Then the day ending with hugs.
Well, actually that's kind of an interesting idea, and we should keep that in mind. Anyone else? Any ideas? What could they possibly be doing? They could have a drink, or juice or cider. Yeah. Or as it's been mentioned before, it would be a nice opportunity for picnic. So that could be there too. And then, you know, I somehow doubt that those four energetic men, six energetic men would be just satisfied with doing something, you know, in one place. Yeah, they could meet, they could have some girl time, they could enjoy the picnic, but something tells me that they would like to change their location and go somewhere together, so they could call this day complete. No, the pony will have to have some other places. For example, the spa. Yeah, that's kind of the place in Bonneville where we often get to see any of my six attending. Okay, picnic. I really love the idea of picnic. Yeah?
I don't know how it would go with the spa, but
the spa? Spa would actually rhyme with the line.
Oh, spa.
Okay. Yeah.
I was thinking if the picnic is in the cloud scale above.
Above. Yeah, but that's actually a good counterpoint.
Yeah.
Well. Well, actually, we have quite a few episodes when Dashi has been spotted in this one. So the secret is kind of out already. So everyone just have to deal with it. But yeah, so let's combine those ideas into something like this. They had the plans that all men love. First, having some good time, the picnic under the clear blue sky, a visit to a spa. Like, you know, this, and this. The plan. Objections? So, as you can see here, that other three lines that are missing, those are going to be something that the body, in our case, is thinking by, that she said while being on her way to meet her friends. Something like thinking aloud. Maybe something nice about her friends, because as you can see, the last line says that her friends would have a dream. Perhaps? Any ideas yet?
Sorry.
Good idea. Can you repeat that again?
This is nice. Some sugar and spice. Exactly what I need. When you said
sugar. Yeah. Yeah, actually, you know, you're kind of winning it. Yeah, we are. You kind of won this one. So, can you please repeat that?
This is nice. Some sugar and spice. Exactly what I need.
Yeah, this is nice. But for the sake of the rhythm of the poem, let's go. Yeah, this is nice. Sugar and spice. Exactly what I need. You know, just the rhythm, to keep the rhythm. And yeah, while I'm writing this down, I'm going to present you the last part of the poem. It's not going to be a large poem, it's just, you know, the example of making the poem. So it doesn't have to be huge, because that would be poem.
This is A-B-A.
Yes! That's the one. And you see, it's another surprise for you, because I have prepared the first and the third one, the third line this time, and the second and fourth you need to complete yourself. So, any ideas so far?
For the last line, this, that, definitely was worth it. But it's
definitely it definitely was worth it. No, it is the AA part. I guess I understand that this part. This AABB to play it. Kind of, each, the pair of lines rhyme with each other. The first one rhymes with the second. And the third one rhymes with the fourth. That's the reason why I have introduced you to the first and the third one.
Oh, so A A B.
Yeah, A A B B.
It's a play.
The fourth line could really be something like it was the one to play, or for the sake of keeping the rhythm of the poem. I'm sure that you could say it was a limit. Yeah, kind of like that. You just need to keep a rhythm. Yeah. Because if the lines constantly contain a different rhythm, it would sound messed up. The idea is
second line back to town in the north.
Back to town in the north? But they are not living poets.
Well, we don't know the reputation of the river and Argos are just
changing. What if the river were to the south?
Well,
yeah.
Then they probably make the town in the north.
Yeah, but let us just remember where she was going. She drove the horse to do what? To go to the picnic, to do what? To meet with your friends, right? So, yeah? What? To meet your friends, but not in the north. Why the north? Because let us say, why the north? It's not like we are talking about crystal and fire. But to meet her friends, yeah, that could be girl. The only thing we need to add is something like of course. You know, with those thoughts, she wrote it what? To spend the day with them, of course, or to meet her friends, of course. just need to keep that rhythm. And if the song is working fast,
so you have very good friends.
To meet with her good friends, of course. Brilliant. I'm totally writing this down. And as we have already agreed, the last line is going to be good. I'm sure that you could say it was a happy day. Yeah. And with that, we actually are completing this poem. But while I'm writing this down, I have actually forgotten about the other two videos, illustrations for the last play video AABB. I have shown you that one. I kind of just jumped to the masterclass because I was afraid we wouldn't have enough time. Nothing more. Thank you. So, do we have a volunteer with the microphone?
No.
So, no?
No.
Use this.
Yeah. Okay, it's working.
Yeah, so, yeah, just raise the hand and the volunteer will find his way to you.
I wanted to know if you have, what influences you have as poets or poems specifically.
Why have I started to write poems?
Why do you influence you, writers or specific poems? Stuff like that.
Unfortunately, it wasn't who but what. You see, as I mentioned before, I come here from Russia. And Russian dub of My Little Pony is one of the worst in the world. So, especially the song. And that goes both to My Little Pony and Linda's Matchup, the other my favorite show. As you can probably get from my cosplay. But yeah, it's not that popular. But you see, when I heard the terrible cry in the translated musical numbers, I just thought, yeah, I get that translating the poem might be hard. Is it really that hard to do professionally? And so I gave it a try to translate a few musical numbers to Russian, myself. And that's how I got into it. Because I kinda succeed. I made the translations far better than what they were on as the official dub. And then I decided to extend it to more than just translations, the right translations, but also, started to write poems. Have anyone been to the GalaCon previous year? Yeah. Do you remember the closet ceremony? Where Rebecca Sherkett read the poem about Happy Birthday Kenny, and that was actually my poem. I couldn't really make it there, but I sent the poem and I was kind of present in the form of my poem. That was a really pleasant thing. So, does that answer your question?
Kind of.
Have you
then gathered some influence from famous poets, or is it strictly balanced?
I guess it's mostly balanced the show. I mean, I occasionally hear some good rhyme, even the rap is getting a lot better at rhyme recently. But as for now, I'm always up for hearing some really good impressive rhyme, and I don't find a lot of from that because I'm not a professional poet or something. I just kind of have talent for it, and I love learning more. Any other question? Okay, let's see where the balloon.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. We are all ears.
Okay, I want to ask, do you have any kind of advice for the aspiring poet, like some sort of tutorials or books that you would recommend?
Actually, the sort of the tutorial is kind of what happened today. That's kind of gives you an idea how it's supposed to be done, what is the easiest way to do it, the easiest ways even. Yeah, the different templates. But as soon as you know that, that doesn't mean that you are going to instantly come up with a good rhyme. Because coming up with rhymes can be difficult sometimes. And it gets difficult to me too sometimes. But what I do at that moment, I can kind of press it and, just because of my experience already, I can kind of press it, just sit like an hour straight on just a few lines and finally get it done. But the better advice would be just take your time, get distracted by something like play video games, go spend time with your friends, and then return to it. And then you will kind of have the idea all sudden. Like it will come. Does that answer your question? Yes. The next one, if we still have time. let's get back to the very beginning. Oh wow, I didn't realize how long it was. Yeah, this is the main body. Yeah, so I try myself in flesh drawing, flesh animation, and also I try myself in singing, though I haven't posted anything yet, but I kind of had to be sort of good at singing because I have a lot of years of music. Yeah, but yeah, I try to explore my possibilities and try myself in different kind of fields, completely different. And there was something else I wanted to mention too, of course, the description. In the description to this project's panel, I've been introduced as a fanfiction writer. Yeah, I kind of write some fanfiction, and a couple of them have even got popular. Like the end, every day of new darkness. Yeah, it's about slender point. Yeah, that's my question. So does that answer your question?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. So, dear volunteers, do we still have time? So, no?
No.
Okay, then it concludes our panel, and thank you all for coming here today. It was a great pleasure to see you all here, and I hope to see you the next year.
Now you can go home.